It's minimalist, budget-friendly, and one of Elon Musk's favorite things in the world. What are we talking about? Well, a tiny home. From picking a style to navigating the arduous building process, a lot of work is involved in constructing your own customized tiny house. How much does it cost to build one? How do you get started? And what are the steps involved in creating a tiny home from scratch? Well, let's explore it in today's video. Number 1. Buy a tiny house trailer. Now, the first step in the manufacturing process is buying the tiny house trailer. It's simple, really. All you have to do is Google the best trailer manufacturer near you that sells custom tiny home trailers for your needs. The average cost of building a tiny home yourself is between $10,000 and $30,000. So the overall investment for it is much less. It's important to remember that unless you have prior experience with fixing up used trailers, it's better to buy a new trailer designed specifically for tiny homes. Additionally, getting one with square fenders and undercarriage flashing options will surely be a plus point. Number 2, decide your floor plan. Next, it's time to create a floor plan. Since the tiny home floor plans vary a lot due to customization options, it's essential to figure out what kind of floor plan suits your needs. Considering where you spend the most time, your sleeping arrangements, and the amount of storage space you need will give you a good idea of what you think your floor plan should look like. So, just map out the life-size version of it somewhere and then alter the floor plan as needed. Number 3. Choose your materials. Of course, any good solid house can only withstand the elements and wear of time if it's made of sturdy, high-quality materials and fixtures. So, after solidifying the floor plan, structural components for framing, roofing, flooring, siding, and insulation are selected. Next, the electrical and plumbing systems, windows, toilet, shower, refrigerator, water heater, air conditioning, heating systems, and other necessary items are selected. Finally, the finishing touches, such as paint colors, fixtures like lighting, hardware, storage cubbies and shelves, and curtains or blinds are picked to perfectly adorn the tiny home. Now, it's time to get down to business and begin the construction process. Number 4. Level your tiny house trailer. Now, it's imperative to level the trailer because the construction must occur on a leveled surface, or else the entire tiny house will be weirdly tilted if it's built on an unleveled foundation. So now, the trailer is leveled on a firm, already leveled surface, so it doesn't cause any problems in the future. Number 5. Insulate your tiny house foundation. After leveling the trailer, it's time to insulate the foundation of the tiny house. The walls, floor, and roof will need all the insulation they can get to weather any storms and chill in the air. The purpose of the insulated subfloor is to provide structural support for finished flooring. Since tiny home trailers already come with part of the subfloor already built into the trailer, all that must be done is insulate this foundation, and cost-effective and do-it-yourself-friendly insulation such as R23 rock wool insulation. It's best to get thicker insulation for better thermal resistance. Number 6. Install subfloor sheathing. Once the tiny home has been insulated, it's time for the next step, which is installing the subfloor sheathing. But before doing that, it's important to note that thermal bridging between the trailer deck and the subfloor sheathing must be prevented at all costs. This helps to reduce the chance of any heat loss through the floors during the winter time through thermal bridging. Anyway, for the sheathing process, TNG plywood or OSB can be used by fastening the boards to the trailer using self-drilling metal-to-wood screws. And there you have it, a perfectly insulated and sheathed tiny house. Now, it's time to move on to the framing process. Number 7. Frame the wall sections. Of course, every house we see has windows and doors, and a tiny home is no different. But before that can be done, the walls must be framed into sections so they can be raised later. So first, you frame the first wall and then square it. A typical wall can have several doors and windows. However, in order to create any window or a door in your wall design, it's necessary to break a series of studs in it to create an opening. Such opening allows the structural loads to be redirected around the opening. This prevents the doors and windows from breaking apart under the loads. Number 8. Raise and secure the wall sections. Alright, so now that the walls have been framed, the next step is to raise them one at a time. And once the walls have been raised and plumbed, they must be prevented from moving by cross-bracing the wall sections. Here, there are two options. If the trailer comes with pre-welded bolts, secure the walls using Simpson strong ties. But if that isn't the case, you can simply drill half-inch holes through the bottom plate, subfloor, and trailer deck. Next, you can use a combination of nuts, bolts, washers, and Simpson strong ties to secure the wall sections to the trailer frame. Now, even after securing the walls, they might seem a little wobbly still. That's perfectly normal because the walls will become fully rock solid once the wall sheathing and roof are assembled later on. Anyway, the final step in this process is to install a section top plate to secure separate wall sections together. Also, it's ensured that the second top plate overlaps wherever two walls join to properly join them. Number 9. Install the lofts. If someone prefers the airy space and relaxing atmosphere a loft provides, they can choose to add one to their tiny house. There are plenty of loft designs out there, and it depends on the manufacturer which one they want to install. After the installation, the loft is sheathed too. To reduce waste and save money, you can use 3/4 plywood or OSB for loft sheathing. It's fastened the same way as subfloor sheathing is done. Another cool thing to note here is that building a loft early in the construction process helps to install roof rafters with ease later on. Fasten the same way as you did in the subfloor sheathing. Number 10. Install the roof rafters. Now, it's time to focus on the roof since we're done with the floor and the walls. This step involves pre-cutting the roof rafters based on the roof design selected before. For most tiny homes, 2x6 roof rafters are sufficient to get the job done. Install house wrap for walls and tar paper for the roof. Since a tiny home differs from your traditional large houses, more thought and effort goes into making it as weather-resistant as possible. For this purpose, the walls are covered in house wraps, a sturdy barrier that shields the tiny home from rain, air, and moisture infiltration, keeping the house dry and cozy. The roof is also covered in tar paper, which serves the same purpose. Alright, now let's bring some doors and windows into play. Number 12. Install windows and doors. Installing the doors and windows is pretty straightforward, but it's crucial to follow the installation instructions provided by the window manufacturer. As for the doors, installing a pre-hung door in tiny homes is always recommended. It's pre-cut and pre-made. So, all that must be done to install it is level, plumb, and insulate. Remember, a nice entry door can make the tiny house look super welcoming and cozy. So, make sure to pick a lovely color and material for it. Number 13. Install the roof. To top it all off, a metal roof is installed. Why metal, you may ask? Well, metal roofing is the most optimal choice because it lasts 50 plus years, it's highly fire resistant, weather resistant, energy efficient, and makes your house look insanely sleek. It's also lightweight and quick and easy to install. So, most manufacturers pick metal roofing for their tiny homes because the benefits definitely outweigh the cost. Now we're heading to the home stretch of the tiny home building. So let's add the final finishing touches to it. Number 14, finishing touches. First up, all the electrical outlets, switches, and indoor and outdoor fixtures are installed. Next, it's time to focus on the plumbing of the tiny home. So the kitchen, bathroom, and shower fixtures will be installed. You can also choose to install a tank or tankless water heater. Plumbing lines, dishwasher, washer, and water heater are also added here. Moving on to the kitchen, it's better to grab some cabinets and countertops from Home Depot, but you can also build them from scratch for a more authentic look. Lastly, the stairs or ladders are installed to access the loft, of course. Just make sure to add handrails. Click on one of the two videos on your screen right now. We'll catch you guys in the next one.